Uterine fibroids are very common. Did you know 3 out of 4 people with uteruses will develop fibroids in their lifetime? Today I'm going to answer the following questions. I'm going to explain what uterine fibroids are, discuss the causes and common symptoms, and explain diagnosis and treatment. What are uterine fibroids? Fibroids are benign growths of muscle that occur in the uterus. They range in size and can grow within the uterus or even push outside the uterus. What causes fibroids? The exact cause of fibroids is still unknown. There are some things that can increase your risk of developing fibroids. People with a parent, sibling, or child with fibroids are 2.5 times more likely to develop fibroids. In addition, increased exposure to estrogen may increase the risk of developing fibroids. Things like obesity or being overweight, getting your period at a young age, or going into menopause later. Birth control pills, however, have not been shown to increase the risk of fibroids or cause them to grow, and we often use them to help treat heavy periods that can occur with fibroids. Fibroids are more common as people age, with more than 7 out of 10 people having fibroids by their late 40s. Fibroids are also more common in people that have high blood pressure or that have become pregnant earlier in their life. Black people with uteruses are nearly 3 times more likely to develop fibroids compared to white people. They can also develop fibroids at a younger age and have more numerous, larger, and more symptomatic fibroids. This difference is not well understood, but it is likely related to environmental exposures, stress, and family history, not race itself. What are the symptoms of fibroids? Most people with fibroids will not experience any symptoms. Others experience symptoms that may significantly impact their quality of life. Common symptoms of uterine fibroids include heavy or prolonged menstrual bleeding, pain with your periods, bleeding between your periods, or pressure in your abdomen or pelvis that can result in frequent urination or constipation. What are some complications of fibroids? It's important to note that fibroids are not cancerous and do not increase the risk of cancer of the uterus. Some fibroids in certain locations or certain sizes may impact fertility or getting pregnant, or increase the risk of complications during pregnancy. That can include miscarriage, an increased risk of needing a C-section, or more bleeding than normal with childbirth. For people with fibroids who do want to become pregnant, ultrasound and MRI exams can be useful to understand the location of the fibroids, their size, and how they might impact your ability to become pregnant or the pregnancy itself. How is someone diagnosed with uterine fibroids? Fibroids are often found during a routine pelvic exam or just noted on an imaging that you were having for a different reason. Your healthcare provider may notice an enlarged or irregular shape to your uterus, and that may suggest that you have fibroids. Ultrasound is the most readily available and lowest cost way to look and diagnose fibroids. It also can help distinguish them from other things that may be causing symptoms. How do you treat uterine fibroids? Treatment options depend on what symptoms someone is experiencing. For those people with mild or no symptoms, watchful waiting may allow treatment to be delayed or even avoided altogether. If someone is in their late 40s, approaching the age of menopause, sometimes just waiting or managing with medications may be preferred over invasive surgery, since the bleeding will stop and the fibroids will decrease in size after menopause. For those with heavy or painful periods, medical management with anti-inflammatory medications like ibuprofen and naproxen, or hormone therapy like birth control pills or a hormonal IUD are very useful and helpful for many people. For those with pain or pressure caused by the size or location of the fibroids, or for those where medications don't help, there are surgical treatments available. Those include a myomectomy, which is removal of the fibroid but leaving the uterus intact, a uterine artery embolization, which is a procedure that shrinks fibroids by decreasing their blood supply, or a hysterectomy may be performed, where the uterus is removed entirely. Fibroids are actually the number one reason for hysterectomies in the United States. When discussing which treatment is right for you, your provider will discuss your fibroid symptoms, effect on your daily activities and quality of life, and whether you plan to become pregnant in the future. If you have fibroids or think you might, please speak to your healthcare provider about the treatment that is best for you.